how does your drinking water impact your gut microbiome? That's what I'm going to chat about today. More specifically, I'm going to chat about a recent 2022 study that was completed with data extracted from the American Gut Project. It's a public database, large sample size, and it looked at how bottled water, tap water, and filtered water, or well water, played a role in different variations of our gut microbiome. But before I dive into that, I'm gonna introduce myself. I'm Taylor, I'm one of the registered dietitians on the Diet Versus Disease team. And today, we are gonna dive into more things gut microbiome related, one of my favorite areas to chat about. So before I dive into the specifics of the gut microbiome, I want to give you a little bit of background around the credibility of this study. So they started with over 15,000 stool samples. However, they wanted to minimize some of the variables we have in our life. And so they actually ended up narrowing it down based on these variables. So alcohol consumption, exercise variance, or extreme exercise variance, and some other chronic health conditions that can impact our gut microbiome in certain ways. So they ended up with just over 3,000 stool samples after adjusting for some of those variables. And so I think it was, 3,413, which is still a fairly large sample size. Again, they had to narrow it down because we want to minimize that variance as much as possible. There's, of course, different variables we still can't account for, and there's different contributions to our gut microbiome. We won't always be able to eliminate all differences because we're still human. However, from there, they then looked at, okay, what are the main bacteria present in individuals that consume these different types of water sources? Again, they looked at tap water, tap city water, well water, filtered water, and bottled water. Let me double check that one. Yes, and bottled water. So those were the four different samples that they looked at, and it was fairly evenly split amongst the population. So what we do know is that our water is full of different microbes, some types of water more so than others, and some types of water will have more beneficial bacteria for us as well. We've known this for a long time, but we haven't really had the evidence to support whether that bacteria present in water impacts our digestive tract. However, this study helps to confirm, or correlate, I should say, that this is likely the case. In fact, drinking well water that is, I should clarify, that is passing all health standards for human consumption, but well water is associated with higher fecal microbial diversity. So more diversity in their microbiome is predicted based on their fecal samples in comparison. So well water is higher in comparison to both tap water, filtered water, and bottled water. More diversity is a good thing within our microbiome for the most part. The hard thing to correlate here is whether or not that's going to increase necessarily that diversity for people who are swapping from one to the other. Not only that, however, the amount of water you drink also plays a really large role. So individuals who drank higher amounts of water, regardless of the type of water, also had an increased amount of healthy bacteria and a reduced amount of bacteria that is linked with gastrointestinal infections and IBS and IBD, a specific campylobacter strain as well. And then lower volumes was associated with lower diversity and higher amounts of these bacteria that aren't great for our digestive tract. And individuals who drank higher amounts of water had an increase in diversity and also a reduction in the campylobacter bacteria that we want less of. Now, what do we do with this information? This is a tough time. This is a tough one to answer because it's going to be quite individual to the person, what's available for them water-wise, as well as your unique digestive health concerns. It's definitely also a little too early in research to recommend people switching their water. But what I do think we can take away here, and I might sound like a broken record, but the importance of water consumption and maximizing our water consumption where we can, being mindful when our water consumption is falling low, as well as being aware that our water source does impact our gut microbiome. The research did show that it didn't play a huge difference in our oral microbiota, but it did in some of the other areas of our gastrointestinal tract or digestive system as well. So although I would say don't go out and dig a well in your backyard today by any means, I would say drink your water, find ways to incorporate it into your day that you enjoy, whether it be putting some fresh peppermint in there. I love basil and pineapple. Be cautious with pineapple if fruit fructans bother you, but some different ways to incorporate it. Now, if you are looking for other ways to support your gut microbiome that you can take action in today, and you're watching this on Instagram or Facebook, comment gut microbiome and we'll send you our gut microbiome guide with some other actionables outside of drinking water that you can do. And if you're watching this on YouTube or on our website, you can also click the link below for more information as well. And as always, if you're looking for some individualized support to really find out what's going to be best for you, let us know. We can hook you up with some options or see if we are a good fit for you as well. As always, I love sharing the latest gut microbiome research with you. I've been reading some awesome stuff coming out recently. I'm so excited to share it with you. Please comment below if you've read this recent study, questions you have, as well as what topics you'd like me to dive a little bit deeper into. Thanks. Bye.